Alright, folks, welcome back to Kingdom Hearts once again here. It's Gamers Comms here, and I'm with my co-host,
Mr. Babel! Senor Babel! Wait, just Mr. Babel, too.
Alrighty. So, Mr. Babel.
And remember, there was a slight delay between this chapter and the next, but it took us less than a year, so we give more of a crap about Kingdom Hearts than Square Enix or Nintendo or Disney.
Damn right. Because after all, this is one of those ultimate nostalgia trips for a lot of people in some ways.
You know, when I was a kid, I never realized... I thought Sora's shoes were stupid, but I never realized he was wearing bright red shorts and bright, basically Mickey Mouse shorts.
Yeah, he pretty much had the whole thing of a Mickey Mouse pattern, color pattern, so to speak.
Hey, in a weird what's way. Happening, man?
But then yep. Again, they wanted Mickey Mouse to be the main protagonist in Kingdom Hearts at first anyways, to begin with. But it's like, no, we're not going to do that. We're just going to have someone made up and let them go from that point onward. And that's
waka,
how Sora
waka,
was
waka.
Yep, and here's Waka from Final Fantasy X. Here we go. Yep, so Waka, he is the long-range character out of the three of Sophie and Titus, or Titus, so however you pronounce it. That awkward laugh, that awkward PS2 laugh.
Still.
You're fine, but... Just a lot of people who are young don't get that joke. Just look up the cutscene from the PS2 or from the remake
of it.
Just look
up Titus laugh. That's all you need. The
breeze feels great.
Yep, and that's the most awkward laugh I ever seen that guy ever do. Probably in video game history, to be honest. Yeah, so basically, Waka just hit the ball back, stun him, and just wail on him, and now Sophie... One who loves trains so much in this whole entire thing, like she did in, what was it, Final Fantasy 8 or 9 or 10, I believe.
Yep.
Was she? Okay. Yeah, I know she was in one of those. But yeah, she is. Very much.
No!
Yeah, so basically, Sophie is the mid range. And yeah, she has a comeback. She gets close to you hitting with her, what was it, jump rope or somewhere like nunchuck thing or whatever. But yeah, you can actually deflect that and actually keep on having that bounce on her head. And I think if you do it just right, you can keep going until you get another level up, but that's a long ways away. So that was the mid range, and then we get to fight Titus, the awkward laughing kid from the PS2 days. So, Babel Play, let me ask you something here. Did you like Titus a lot from Final Fantasy X?
X was... I don't know. Remember, I'm old enough that when I was a little kid, I played Final Fantasy. I played them all pretty much through 8. And then
right.
8 was kind of the
Sora,
death.
You feel lucky today?
Even 7 pissed me off, because even though it was awesome,
uh-huh.
It felt more like they should have called it Final Sci-Fi than Final Fantasy. I don't
just...
mind it, it's just that I like fantasy more than I like sci-fi, and it felt like they had, it felt like more and more what I had enjoyed as a series that started with a little, you know, a little bit of Magitek armor and stuff like that in 3, gradually turned into, this isn't fantasy anymore, this is very blatantly, you know, magical science fiction.
Kind of like the movie they had at one point, which is, what was it? I forget which movie it was. Someone out there would know
the
it.
The Spirits
but...
Within.
Yep, that was it. Just like The Spirits Within. Jeez. Let's see how many people actually remember that movie now for Final Fantasy.
People who saw it don't remember it. It was so forgettable, had absolutely nothing to do with the series. And yes, people will say, well, none of the Final Fantasy games are integrated. Bull honky. It did not have a reference. He did not have even a reference to
yep.
Chocobos or Moogles or anything from the Final Fantasy universe.
Hell, Chocobos and Moogles have been in every freaking Final Fantasy game there is, just as much as CPO and
R2-D2. Actually, I don't think Moogles came along until the 3rd one. Chocobos were definitely
yeah.
in all of them.
Pretty much the equivalent to that. That's like, say, C3PO and R2-D2 have been in every Star Wars movie up to this date, pretty much.
Including the Christmas special.
Let's not go into...
Whipster! Whipster!
Let's not go into that territory.
fair warning to those of you who aren't familiar with my channel, I rely very heavily on whatever pop culture reference can pop into my head.
Hey, it all works.
Sometimes it's glorious, and other times I just start singing the song from Robot Unicorn Cat.
Oh, here we go.
I had to download that onto my phone the other day just because I had it stuck on my in my head. And sometimes the only way to get a song out of your head is to actually hear it all the way through it.
Yeah, that's happened to me there.
It really helps, especially with a song you don't really know a lot, because the human brain wants completion. And so once you get it, it can let go.
Yeah, just like with me when it comes to, like, to some TV intro songs. Like what was it?
Or it's like Cartman with the Come Sail Away.
Yeah, that's very true. But yeah, so I forgot to mention here. Yeah, you can actually take all three of these guys at once here and everything else. The best strategy to do is to actually keep near the water so that way they all come at you instead of just, you know, you having to run around and get
everyone
else.
You effectively got your back to a wall so they can't come up behind you.
Basically, yeah. Because if you decide to swim away, yeah, you lose that battle, basically. And it's like, well, you can't die in any of these here, so, I mean, what's the point of using a potion? That's a freaking waste. That's a noobish move. Don't ever do it in these battles. Just don't do it. Because you can't die in any of these. These are like...
Okay, at least it's not one of those stupid... What I really hate is they give you no warning, but it's a scripted battle where no matter how good you do, the boss will kill you in the end. And you've used all your potions, all your megatonics, all your elixirs, you know, everything. It's bullcrap, and it's not funny.
Especially when it's like, what? What do you mean it was part of the story purpose?
Yeah. I'm sorry, but it should tell you or give you some kind of indication.
Yeah.
Like, I can't remember what game it was, but there was one game where I was really pissed off because they took all my items before the fight. And then it was because they didn't want you using up your rares.
And it's like, well, that's nice of you, game. But I don't think I was going to be that stupid enough to do it, but jeez. So, except for Riku here, at least when you first fight him here, or at least in day one or whatever. Yeah, Riku, if you hit him about, like, 3 or 4 times, he'll go on his back and do that, like, launch kick, or whatever you want to call it, basically. So what you see me doing is just hitting about once, then 1, 2, or whatever. And there's sometimes where I do get hit in this, but in other times before, I got lucky where Riku has not hit me once. But that's because I actually learned how to play this game, that's all. Which took a long while, but hey, everyone has the game to play now. And we actually beat Riku finally in all this.
Yay!
And you get a potion for this. And now... I don't know if it's in either in this one here, where actually if you fight everyone, or if when you have to race Riku, yeah, that's gonna happen in this video, so that shouldn't be no shocking surprise here. But basically, you get what's called a pretty stone, and as a tip, if you want some amount of money at the beginning when you hit into Traverse Town, well, you want to stock up on a bunch of pretty stones, and then you can sell them all off, and you can have some kind of money there and all that stuff.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to have enough money not to buy salt flavored ice cream.
Oh, right. Sea salt ice cream. I love it.
Could be.
I'm sure it's not salt. We'll never I'm know sure. By staying here.
Right.
Otherwise, they're a bunch of cow people eating it salt.
Who knows?
Mm-hmm. And now we get into this cutscene.
Oh, wait.
Here.
Sea salt ice cream is from this island. So, not forever. Forever. Suppose you get to another world. Sorry, I'm screwing up because of a really old dumb joke a friend of mine used to have where there should have been a secret level called Trevor's Town where there was just one guy there named Trevor and he would like run around and put on a fake mustache and be the guy behind every store and then put on a big hat and he'd be the guy at the hotel. And, no, I'm sure you're thinking of someone else. That must be my cousin.
Now, for people who actually get that reference, either A, you play a lot of games, or you just like to look into some other older stuff here.
Well, if they get it, they've either heard of Traverse Town, as you mentioned, or the one guy fulfilling every role dates all the way back to the Three Stooges sketches, and probably before that.
Probably.
Then it goes to vaudeville, if not, you know, Shakespearean era productions.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same old stuff.
Also, why are there no more strong... I need to not talk.
You've
been thinking a lot
lately, haven't you? You're fine there.
Thanks to you.
Oh, I hate it.
If you hadn't come here, I probably...
Comment down below. Girl, why they talk during cutscenes? I hate when they do that. Sad face, angry face.
Although, on the other hand, I'm sure it's not that hard to find a no-commentary playthrough if you want it.
Yeah, basically, for those guys who don't want the commentaries, hearing all that stuff of our lovely voices that we have, well, basically, there is a non-commentary and us here.
He's hitting on you, Sora. Don't miss this opportunity.
You know the fan goes to say, go for it, man! Go for it, Sora! Hit that ass! Or something like that.
You know, all of this might never have... All the horror that's about to happen might never have... or might not have been nowhere as bad if he had just friggin' kissed Riku right then. Seriously?
Yeah. Wait, Riku, come back! We're supposed to do this thing!
Sasuke! I mean, Riku!
Naruto, I mean, Sora!
Remember, no matter how awesome the people of Disney Universe are, you're really bad at architecture.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, those towers were warped.
Very much so. And okay. For Pete, go ahead.
I don't trust those brooms. Why are they trusting those brooms to carry water?
Maybe they're trying to drown out something. I don't know what's going on. Who knows what goes on in this Disney universe?
Hey, Donald, here's an idea. Just in advance, you'll need to know this. Don't cast heal when we've lost one hit point.
Yeah, okay, Donald, just don't do it. You'll see what we mean later on during this whole playthrough of this game.
Oh god, I usually turn their special effects off, their automatic attacks off.
Yeah.
I tell them, just don't heal, don't bother.
No, I'm more than capable of doing that myself now. And...
Okay, now my brain just pictured just some guy standing there looking pissed off with a little scratch on his arm with Donald and the big, heavy black guy coach from Left 4 Dead 2 fighting over, I want to heal him. No, man, I'm going to use a health pack on him.
Yeah, I can see that happening. Yeah, So, for people who may not know this, earlier during that little cutscene, if you listen to the music carefully, that's the Mickey Mouse Club theme song, the original one there. Very
the
old
leader
school.
Of the club that's made for you and me.
M-O-U-S-C.
Hey there, hi there, ho there. You're as welcome as can be.
Mickey
Come
Mouse.
Along and sing the song and join the jamboree. M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Never heard of it.
As he just sang all of it, basically.
Yeah. The Mickey Mouse Club actually came back in the 2000s, like where Britney Spears and like either Justin Timberlake or one of those boy band guys got started.
Yeah.
Yeah, not many people know that anymore, but Britney Spears started off on the new Mickey Mouse Club.
Yes, and that's very true. And one of the boy bands also did here too. And oh crap, there's the missus.
Well, not the boy band, just Justin Timberlake, whoever. Just one of them.
Oh yeah, that's right. And the missus overheard what was going on. And
also, when I was a kid, I thought Goofy was stupid for fighting with two shields. And then as I grew up and learned just how much damage you can do ramming with, you know, a solid blunt object like that, I'm like, that's really solid protection, and it's got crap range, but anybody close enough is gonna, you know, get bones smashed.
I know, it's almost a perfect attack and defense at the same time.
Well, not perfect, but it's pretty damn, it's a lot better than I thought it was when I was 12.
Or, yeah, I know, right? Tidus, we are gonna do a little exploring
today. You know, Tidus. To the secret place at the base of that tree. I like girls with big Tidus.
Yeah? Oh, yeah, that one secret part way back over there, you know, that's not so secret when the camera pans it over. Just saying, but whatever. But yeah, we're gonna go take a look in here, and also, oh wait, are we? I forget when I record this, it's been a while here. Yeah, so everyone moves around, and now the front of the island, and now you get access to the back of the island, I guess, I don't know, something like that. And then this is where, if you had enough fighting and all that stuff with Riku, well, now you get a racist butt now.
Oh yeah! time for a little good old-fashioned Disney racism.
Zippity-doo-da, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. What made the red man red?
I don't remember the song from the Aristocats, but remember that Chinese
cat
playing piano with chopsticks?
Yeah.
Everybody wants to be a cat.
A cat.
Am I leaving out any blatant Disney racism?
Not that I know of. Well, I think that's... Well, wait, got one... You got one from the Lady and the Tramp there, too.
Let's not forget Sunflower.
Yeah.
You know who Sunflower was, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
The little black donkey centaur, the one who was part donkey when all the others were when all the white ones were horses, and it was her job to just treat their hair and crap. And somehow she got cut out of future releases of Fantasia. Uh-huh. So their solution to, instead of making a decent, you know, editing in a, you know, respect, I guess editing in too much work, but still, cutting her out completely is almost as offensive as having an offensive character in the first place.
You can't win for losing. Yeah, Sora, you will be such a great captain. We will see this stuff go on. No, I mean me, Riku. Wait, what? Yeah, so instead of just having the island music going on, I'm like, sure, why not? Let's go ahead and have some Daycon music racing going on. Why not? People who actually have played this game, played that game, he actually made which track I actually used.
They never actually made the action figures, but one monster in the game got a prototype action figure. Care to guess which one it was?
Are you asking me or the viewers on that one?
All of you. You go ahead and guess, and they can guess too.
I thought it would have been something like the Trick Master or the Armor Guard is what I would have thought, but I don't know.
I'll give you a hint. I'll give you a hint. Smoke some pot and find a spider.
Ow.
Yeah, the pot spider.
Of all things. Okay, then. And also, folks, if you guys want to get a little bit of a, what was it here, extra boost in defense, way over here where I'm taking this crate here, there is a defense chain up or something. I forget what's pronounced here nowadays. But yeah, so that way you can actually go ahead and get an extra bonus here. I think I got interrupted while I was recording, so you see me kind of standing still for a little bit. Just had to take care of something real quick.
And I saw her standing there. She was just 17, and you know what I mean. Loving for too long. I fell in love with her. She wouldn't dare. Okay, I have no idea why the hell I'm singing. Okay. I both blame and give credit to my mom, because when I was growing up and everybody else was listening to 80s music, she was listening to the 50s and 60s on the radio, on the oldies channel. So while I do have an appreciation for 80s music, I also know lots of older music most people my age don't.
Which is somehow going, what, you know that?
Seagull egg.
Yep, so, yeah, tip up
what
we never...
What do seagulls do to you, you son of a fish?
And the thing here...
So how come we're dressed like Mickey, but she's not dressed like Minnie? Seriously, she should be running around topless with a skirt.
Wouldn't that just be convenient now or what? I mean, we are Mickey. Well, yeah, you already said it there, basically. Yeah, so all this stuff you're getting for the trip. Yeah, you have to collect the yellow coconuts, not the brown ones. No, that would just be too easy. No. It has to be the special yellow ones.
Aren't yellow coconuts not ripe yet and the brown ones are?
That's what I thought.
No,
but...
green. I would think they'd be green and then kind of yellow and then to brown.
Yeah, I thought brown was like, okay, you can eat us now. There we go. Yeah, and to think all this stuff.
I just remember a line from Simpsons. Mm-hmm. Was, hey, we've heard of Springfield. Is it true you have to bring your own water? Nah, we just have a saying. If it's brown, drink it down. If it's black, send it back.
And to think here, all this stuff we're getting for this one whimsical trip we're having, we're not even going to use any of this items.
Oh, no. Seriously, I think if you've already played this game, you should have the option to just go back and tell her, yeah, I got all the stuff. It's totally in the box. No need to check.
No, seriously, it's in there. What do you mean you want me to open it? I just told you. It's all okay. Good.
Now I want a Kingdom Hearts with Warner Brothers here.
So
just imagine teaming up with, like, Yakko, Wakko, and Dot, or, oh, God. As a punishment level for assholes, maybe, like, the Lunatics Unleashed. And you have to get together and play basketball until you apologize.
Oh, Lunatics. That was such a different time period.
It's really not fair of me to bash on it, just because I admit I have never actually given a chip a chance. I've just seen clips, and those were enough to make me go, ugh! They're all smart-ass, you know, wannabe Sonic the Hedgehog assholes.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sorry, but Sonic was awesome in his day, but he was an asshole.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and here I'm just kind of showing this off because I don't think anyone else has done this. But yeah, if you'll take your time to looking at all of these here, you actually get to see either Donald or Goofy on one of these walls here and all that stuff.
Hey, did you ever watch Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog?
Yes, I have, and I also have the DVDs for that series too.
Would you say that either Scratch or Grounder was in any way mentally functional competent?
Functional to eat and breathe, but other than that, not really.
Would they? Let's pretend you put their brains in a human body. Would they be able to function in real life?
Oh hell no!
So doesn't that mean Sonic was mentally abusing the mentally handicapped?
I guess so in some ways. There. Wow! 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 Yeah.
I mean,
so
I'm not trying to point fingers or nothing, but seriously, he was abusive and deliberately deceitful to people who couldn't, you know, and I mean, Robotnik made them, so he apparently made them stupid and then yelled at them for screwing up. So I think everybody there would be.
Yeah, the Scratch and Grounder. Folks, if you haven't seen the show by this point, just go watch it. Go watch a few clips of it here and there or something, and you'll get the idea.
Nostalgic people tell you that it's absolutely terrible, but I will tell you, if you're in the mood for an awesome Sonic show, yeah, it's garbage. If you're in the mood for something just goofy, silly, funny, it's not as bad as a lot of people say it is.
Oh, yeah, I mean,
If you want something stupid funny, it's really good stupid funny. Okay, mm-hmm. Son, he's very bad at illustrating. Good job.
I've come to see the door to this world.
Yes, I am ruining this innocent this child love.
Oh, yes, I mean, some of them are, gonna be teenagers by this point. I'm going into teenagerhood by this.
I'm sorry, but Kyrie's already got enough boobs that I think I can make sex jokes.
And thus begins. Stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Yeah, you hit Sora. Stop freaking me out about this whole boob jokes, man.
You do not yet know.
Made wonders beyond
the door. I know, I'm just saying.
Dude, I made a much longer homoerotic joke about Sora and what's his name? About her. So
very yeah, I know.
All right. Just making sure you know. So little.
Oh yeah. Well, you'll see. Now, correct me if I'm wrong here, but they got Billy Sane to do this, do Ansem and this guy here, isn't this here right? Who
knows? I think so.
Yeah. See, it's been a while since I had to look up the facts for this game here. Ominous door.
I never realized as a kid just how freaky blue Sora's eyes are.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, but he looks like he's been eating too much worm spice.
Yeah. And to think here, this cave has a whole bunch of different pictures from different, what it looks like. Oh, hey, look, different worlds, this and that. Donald's on one of the freaking walls over here of all things. I'm thinking I showed off everything here. I don't know.
Let's see. Picture of Goofy. Mickey Mouse logo. Here I sit, all brokenhearted. Oh, wait, never mind.
All right, now after we've gone done talking to Mr. Mysterious Guy over here, aka I am not the bad guy or some crap like that. Now we gotta go back to Kyrie after we get the seagull egg. You'd be surprised that the seagull doesn't try to attack us, even though we're just a human being. But whatever. Are we there yet? No.
I don't know, but the screen has been black a while. There we go.
Yeah, let's get it going. There we go. Yeah, folks, I wanted to get off of Destiny Island by this point. Just kind of get going into the real part of the game. At least this isn't like Roxas and it's 2-hour tutorial about things, at least. So, here's one of the first things and final myths that you never got to see here in the United States here, basically.
Look at it this way. At least it's not Psychonauts.
Oh, yeah.
I love Psychonauts. It's an awesome game. But you are effectively gaining new powers and learning how to use them for the entire first half of the game, making the game half tutorial. Then after you've learned all your attacks, then I guess the real game begins because the difficulty spikes sharply.
Oh yeah, and anyone that played Psychonauts, they'll know what Babble Play is talking about. I should know because I started playing Psychonauts and I'm going, can we just get on with the game already?
Maybe not watch the Psychonauts Babble Play. It was one of my first, and I'm planning to redo it in HD. So, unless you just want to hear my old crappy quality, then I would just wait a little while.
Okay. Right.
I'm trying to redo almost everything I can now that I'm doing HD, because I was half-assing at first. Because, let's be honest, editing in HD takes forever, and uploading in HD takes longer. And I was lazy little whore that thing.
Tina, I was a little afraid at first, but now I'm ready. Teenager romance talk.
I know I can always come back. Oh my god, I saw an ad on the internet somebody was doing a list of the most disturbing actually released, you know, not joke, not fan-made, actually published porn titles.
Uh-huh.
And I can't remember what the others were, but I think, like, number 3 should have been number 1. And it was 10-inch Mutant Ninja Turtles. And I was looking at the cover, I'm going, those guys are normal size. They're not only 10 inches tall.
Jeez. And now, if someone wanted to do Mickey Mouse's voice here, this is where he's talking about, sorry guys, I have to go find what's this causing all this trouble of Heartless to come around. Basically enough, as this is all going on. And you would have thought in this world we got to see some more Disney World. I mean, yeah, we get to see some more later on, but there's some that you would have thought would have actually made in the first 2 games, at least, if nothing else. Fine, Leon. Yeah, everyone should know who Leon is without looking it up, you cheating bastards.
This mean? It means we'll just have to trust the king.
Gorge, I sure hope he's all right.
Goddess, don't worry. We'll find the king and the key.
Right.
Thank you.
This huge-ass key we're gonna be trying to find throughout most of this game. Okay, maybe not really, but you get what I mean.
You be careful now, both of you.
And to chronicle your travels, he will accompany you.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Conscience himself, the one and only Jiminy Cricket.
Cricket's the name. Jiminy Cricket at your service.
You know, people, after many games later, we had to have another game that recaps everything, and that's Recoded. AKA, I waste the time of a game.
You do know he died in the book, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do.
In the first, like, chapter, he, like, tried to give Pinocchio advice, and Pinocchio splattered him on the wall with a hammer, and then his ghost showed. I was like, screw you! From now on, I'm just following you around and giving you conscience advice.
Basically, and this is how Jiminy
Cricket
is.
No one asked him to do it. No one, you know, he just... seriously, read Pinocchio. It's like a weird acid trip/dream.
And also, it's a fun fact, the author of that book, he didn't like children, so you can actually kind of see it in the writing.
You know what he did like?
Huh.
Bacon sandwiches. He would order one almost every day.
Mm-hmm.
And remember, he was British, I believe, or Italian. So he's not using the thin American cut. He was using slabs.
Yeah. Not what we use over here.
Now, if you're an American and you go to, over to Europe and you order a bacon sandwich or bacon with anything, you're going to get this huge, glorious slab of joy.
And then you were like, what have I been missing out on? Oh, look, it's the gummy ship, a.k.a. the wannabe of Star Fox. This is going to be... Yeah, so
I'm
folks...
I'm a gummy ship. Yes, I'm a gummy ship. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, lucky gummy ship. Oh, yeah, yummy, gummy, 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 gummy ship.
Let's see how many people actually know that reference without looking it up. Now, you would have thought Chip and Dale actually would have talked in the first game, but no, they just have little, like, subtitles, but they don't really talk in this game at all. This is, like, the only time
they
have voices.
They didn't talk in the earliest cartoons.
Yeah, that's true now, isn't it? Now, let me ask you something here, Babbleplay.
But if most of us grew up with Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers.
Yeah. Well, we know everyone knows that show. There.
I'm having a... Well, we're almost done with the episode, and my all right, is my internet disconnected? Are you there?
No, I'm still here.
Okay, because I've got that... The video is stopped, and I've got that swirly thing in the middle of the screen.
I'm at 3149.
3126, but it's okay. We've only got, like, 3 minutes left.
Yep.
So I will live. There we go. I skipped it ahead a bit.
Yep, I'm at 32 minutes now here.
Yeah, I never lived long first because I tried to make my entire ship out of guns.
Nothing but guns.
It could tear through enemies like nobody's business.
Which is kind of something. Now, for folks, if anyone's asking me, how am I going to do the gummy ship? At first, I'll show what it's like going there from point A to point B. For the rest of it, I'm just either going to either cut it out or speed it up. Unless it's for story purposes.
I have actually started building giant gummy
fly
around.
Man, that guy's a dick.
Yeah, and I'm like 13 or 14.
Only time you ever hear the parents ever talking is for Sora here. And yes, that's right, folks. We're getting closer to the end as we get back to the island and everything else. And shit's about to go down.
Actually, we are nowhere near the end. He just lied to you.
Well, I mean the end of this video anyway.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that we're very close to.
Yep, folks. So, yeah, Heartless and Fade, and this is where your useless sword is useless. That should be obvious.
Yep. First the Heartless, then the Nobodies.
And many more here. And folks, we'll
and
see
then
you guys.
I don't want to call it a fanfic because it wasn't actually a story so much as just my teenage scraping together what I thought the third game would be. First the Nobodies, then the Heartless. I mean, the Heartless, then the Nobodies, then the Almost Were.
Right.
People who could have been born, but just something happened and they weren't.
Yep. So, folks, we'll see you next time on Kingdom Hearts here, and thanks for the listeners. Well, it's in his name. Us babble along with us here and giving commentaries.
Be safe, be well, be happy.
See you around.
Bye-bye.